message to the House Committee. Secretary for Transport and Housing. President, I move the second reading of the Landlord and Tenant Consolidation Amendments Bill 2021. The government has all along been concerned about the living condition of households living in subdivided units, SDUs. The chief executive announced the setting up of the task force for the study on tenancy control of subdivided units last year to study if tenancy control on SDUs should be introduced in Hong Kong and the feasible options to safeguard the interests of SDU tenants. In the light of public concerns, the task force completed a study early by 3 months and submitted a report to the government at the end of March this year. The task force recommends suitable tenancy control on SDUs and proposes a regulatory framework and a series of measures. As we reported to the Subcommittee on Issues Relating to Transitional Housing and Subdivided Units of the Legislative Council on the 26th of April this year, the government has carefully considered the report of the task force and is of the view that the proposed tenancy measures, if implemented, would achieve our objective of providing a reasonable degree of protection to SDU tenants. We therefore accept in principle the recommendations of the report of the task force. We would follow the suggestion of the task force to prepare an amendment bill to amend the Landlord and Tenant Consolidation Ordinance and add a new Part 4A to effect tenancy control on SDUs. Members have expressed support in general and have urged the administration to submit the reference bill to the Council as soon as possible for the early implementation of SDU tenancy control. At the Chief Executive's question and answer session on the 4th of February this year, the Chief Executive undertook to submit the bill to the Legislative Council within this legislative session for the implementation of SDU tenancy control. We have completed the drafting of the bill, and the Chief Executive in Council agreed at its meeting last Tuesday that the bill be tabled at the Legislative Council for scrutiny. The legislative proposal in the bill is primarily formulated on the basis of the framework put forth by the task force. Due consideration has been given to the guiding principles adopted by the task force. While the legislative proposal provides reasonable protection to STU tenants, it would not disproportionately infringe on the property rights of owners, as we try to minimize the consequence of contradiction with our intention. We have also included appropriate measures to address problems caused by subletting and adopted tenancy control measures which are legally sound, relatively easy to administer, and which can be implemented speedily. In the drafting process of the bill, the biggest challenge we encountered was with a legal definition of SDUs and setting the scope of regulation. We note that SDUs do not only exist in domestic buildings, but also in industrial and commercial buildings or in temporary structures such as squatter structures and rooftop houses. As a fact, some SDUs may involve illegal land use and or unauthorized building works. If tenancy control also covers these illegal SDUs, a misleading message may be sent to the public that the government is legalizing these SDUs. At the same time, we recognize that tenants living in these SDUs may be even more vulnerable than those living in SDUs in normal domestic buildings and are even more in need of tenancy protection. The task force, concerned groups, and many LegCo members from major political parties are also of the view that STU tenancy control should offer protection to as many STU tenants as possible. Consequently, the bill covers different types of buildings, including SDUs in domestic buildings and industrial and commercial buildings. In general, the bill covers various types of subdivided units in these buildings, such as cubicles, bed spaces, capsules, cock lofts, caged housing, rooftop houses, podium houses, and so on. We must, however, make it clear that the bill is not meant to legalize SDUs in industrial and commercial buildings or temporary structures, and the implementation of tenancy control would not prejudice law enforcement actions taken by relevant authorities under existing legislation, particularly in respect of building and fire safety. The tenancy control regime proposed in the bill includes mandating the signing of a written tenancy agreement by SDU landlords and tenants to set out the rights and obligations of both parties, providing security of tenure to tenants for a total of 4 years, restricting the rate of rent increase upon renewal of tenancy by mandating reference to the change of the rental index in respect of all classes of private domestic properties compiled by the Rating and Valuation Department, and capping the increase at 15% every 2 years, as well as prohibiting landlords from overcharging tenants on public utility tariffs such as water and electricity tariffs. We believe the implementation of the proposed tenancy control measures could achieve our policy objective of providing reasonable protection to SDU tenants while not undermining unduly the interests and property rights of SDU landlords. The measure would offer security of tenure to SDU tenants and prevent the overcharging of water and electricity tariff, as well as arbitrary rent increase by landlords. President, SDU tenancy control is an extremely complicated and controversial issue. The speedy completion of the drafting of the bill is owed much to the hard work of the task force, the support and comments rendered by members of this council and non-government organizations in the process, and not least, the dedicated effort of the relevant government departments. It all goes to show our determination in safeguarding the interest of SDU tenants. I hope the Council will complete the scrutiny of the bill as soon as possible for it to be passed before the end of this legislative session. This would allow the SDU tenancy control measures to be implemented as early as possible. We would fully support the work of the Council in the scrutiny of the bill, and we will continue to listen to the views of members and the public. President, I so submit. I now propose the question to you that the aforesaid bill be read the second time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Commerce and Economic Development.